With me now, I have Tara. Tara, you're one of the main organisers of today's event. Can you tell me how happy were you with what happened today?
I was absolutely thrilled because we weren't sure, because it was such short notice, we weren't sure how many people would turn up. Would it be 10, would it be 20, 30? And when we saw the 100 starting together, we were really, really happy.
Was the walkout around the roundabout, that spontaneous?
Yes. The crowd decided that they wanted to do it, and we couldn't stop them, so if that's what they wanted to do. And it seems to have got a great result and a great reaction, so we're really happy.
Yeah, because it did stop traffic on the N25 as well, which was part of today's plan. Overall, I mean, how confident are the group, we'll say, in retaining the ambulance here on y'all?
Well, in the last week, it seems to be picking up momentum. We're getting an awful lot of coverage in newspapers. We were on TV3 last night. A lot of people seem to be picking up on the story. And the more people that pick up on it and the more national press that we get, I think the more chance we have of getting a message to the HSC that y'all is not going to take this line down.
I mean, after the meeting the other night at the Water Valley Hotel, there was a huge crowd there. Were you even expecting that?
No, we were expecting maybe between 200 and 300 people.
Right.
And from the door tally, we seem to have got over 800. And even yesterday on the street, there were people who actually turned up and went away because they couldn't get into the hall.
Excellent stuff. What's next? What's the next part of the plan for this group?
Well, obviously there's meetings being organised with the HSC. We have nearly a guarantee that they will speak with us. So when that happens, we don't know, but hopefully within the next 2 weeks. We have another protest organised for, hopefully, it's not definite, it's not confirmed, for Saturday week, but we'll be doing it through the town.
So through the town, Saturday week will be the next thing.
And we would be hoping then that clubs would turn out in their, you know, their rugby uniforms or their soccer jerseys, theatre companies would turn out, maybe the fire brigade, you know, coast guards, that kind of thing, make it big. And hopefully maybe we might even get the All Black Band to start us off.
That'd be great if we could get that, because it is something that the whole community wants.
Yeah, I think so. I mean, I think y'all is more passionate about this subject because y'all went out of its way years ago to buy the very first ambulance that came here so that lives wouldn't be lost. And now to say after all these years that we're going to take a step backwards and lose the ambulance again from this area is just, to me, it's beyond belief. It's crazy.
Tara, thank you very much.
No problem. Thanks a million.
Your ambulance! Save your ambulance!
First of all, we want an answer. We want an answer because we have not been given an answer as to why they are deciding to take y'all ambulance, a vital service here in the town, an essential service here in the town. If we get no answer there, we'll go further. We go to HSE headquarters, we go to Dáil Éireann, we go to the minister's office. No matter what it takes, like, we all aren't going to take this line down. And I, to be honest with you, this isn't going to stop until the decision is reversed.
For the people of y'all, have you any message, a personal message?
Just keep fighting. Just keep fighting. Keep hammering on to whoever listen, be it 96 FM, be y'all online, whoever it is. Just keep at it, and let's make sure that we get the outcome that we all want.
Thank you very much. Own kind. I love you all. Thank you.